Hello, everyone, and welcome back to another edition of the JagerBombs NHL DFS Shots of the Night. We'll be looking at tonight's NHL slate. We've got 8 games on Thursday, December 13th. I'm Chris Durrell. I'm here for RotorPros.com. If you're not a member of RotorPros.com yet, make sure to get over to the website as you see here. Go to the sign-up button, and you can get yourself a two-week free trial. Gives you access to our premium content, our articles, cheat sheets. The biggest thing is we've got a community chat, Slack chat, where we provide all of our daily content, including those cheat sheets, premium articles. We've got one-on-one coaching in chat rooms, and then we've got our skeleton lineups that we provide every day as well. Industry standard, where we leave 2 or 3 players out of the lineups just to kind of give you a feel of our core players. And then we, like I said, one-on-one coach to help you outfill those final spots, along with the plays that we highlight in our NBA, NHL, PGA, NASCAR, soccer, all the kind of content that we provide. So make sure to get that over. Pretty sure you're going to stick around after that two-week free trial and get your daily, monthly, or yearly membership. With that said, let's jump right into the slate here tonight. I'm going to go to my cheat sheet first of all. And we're looking at, like I said, we've got an 8-game slate tonight. We've got 2 games, Florida at Minnesota and Toronto at Tampa Bay with 6.5 over-unders. We've got 3 other games, Los Angeles at Columbus, Carolina at Montreal, Edmonton at Winnipeg, 4 games, sorry, Dallas at San Jose, all with 6 over-unders. And then 2 smaller totals tonight, Vancouver at Nashville and Arizona at Buffalo, sitting there at 5.5. So, as you can see, we've only got 1 team, Dallas, on a back-to-back. We've got 1 team playing a 3rd and 4, that's the Los Angeles Kings. And then if you're new to the cheat sheet, make sure to come over and check it out. We've got offense versus opponent defense ratings. We've got home road splits. We've got power play versus the other team's penalty kill. We've also got advanced stats here for teams as well as on the player level, and those come from naturalstattrick.com. Excellent site. Be sure to go check that out. And then you get into the individual tabs here. You're going to see the goalies when they are confirmed. I put a Y beside them. They highlight in orange, just telling you that that goalie is confirmed to be starting for tonight. Any players that you see in green are going to be my core plays. Anything you see in blue are going to be GPP plays. And then we've also got their regular stats as well as advanced stats in the blue column here as well on the player level. And then we've got team stats to correlate there as well. And that goes through centers, wingers, defense. And then if you want to check out more stats, you can go into the team stats, home road splits. That's where I pull all those stats from. You can go check out those as well for doing your research there as well. So as you can see, there's a lot of plays on the sheet. So I'm only going to cover 2 at each position in this video to try and keep it short and to the point. And then after that, make sure before lock to go and check out this cheat sheet to get all the top plays. And I will be adding stacks once I am done this video. So let's jump into the picks here. So first of all, we're going to go over goalies, and the top one, top of my projections tonight is Pekka. He's a 2-220 home favorite. He's the highest priced goalie on both sites. I do like paying up for cash games. Rene leads the league in goals against average with a 191 and save percentage at a 932 save percentage. And then looking at his advanced stats as well among all qualified goalies, he leads them all with a 956 save percentage at 5-on-5 and 928 save percentage when facing high danger scoring chances. So that is like elite class leading everyone. So the Canucks are 15th overall in offense. They did score 4 goals on Nashville in Vancouver. I believe it was 4 games ago. This would be a week ago now. They are scoring 2.94 goals per game, but have been trending down over their last 15 games, scoring just 2.5 goals per game, so I'm not really worried about that. Rene's the best goalie in the league. The only thing downside with him is that he doesn't face a ton of shots. I think he's averaging around 27, 28 shots a game. That kind of caps the upside, but he has really good win potential, so I'm definitely looking at him in cash games. For GPPs, I'll be looking at Sergei Bobrovsky tonight. He's only 7,900 on DraftKings, 8,400 on FanDuel. The Blue Jackets are also -220 home favorites. I say GPP only for Bobrovsky just because he's struggled overall this season. He's won 2 Vezina trophies in the past, so we know he's a really good goaltender. He has flashed a bit of that upside this season with 9 of his starts where he's allowed 2 or fewer goals. So, I mean, if you are liking your construction of your forwards and your defense and you need that little bit of extra salary room, 500 on DraftKings or 600 on FanDuel, I definitely wouldn't argue with you if you wanted to get Sergei Bobrovsky in cash games tonight. But for myself, I'm leaning Rene, going to build around him, and then Bobrovsky for GPPs. Bobrovsky does face a Kings team that sits at the bottom of the standings this season, and they also rank dead last in road offense, scoring just 1.71 goals per game. Moving on to centers, Jack Eichel, I've talked about him a lot this year. He's really starting to come into his own in the NHL. He's providing, like, he is the most expensive center on DraftKings, a little bit cheaper on FanDuel tonight. So he might be a little bit lower on DraftKings just because of that, because you've got Tavares, you've got Austin Matthews, you've got Stamkos, you've got Point. Those four centers are all involved in that Tampa Bay-Toronto game with a 6.5 total. So a lot of people might just go for Michael, save a little bit, and grab one of those guys in that other matchup. So I think he could, he's definitely in play in all formats for me, providing a very high floor with 52 shots in his last 10 games. With an elite 13.2 shots per 60 and 19.6 individual Corsi on the season. You can check out those advanced stats on my sheet. And if you want a, you know, a little bit of a definition of what those stats are going to mean, definitely head over to naturalstattrick.com, go to the bottom of the page and click on glossary. That's going to tell you everything you need to know about all these stats. But pretty much shots are just broke down into the per 60 level, just to kind of compare everyone a little bit closer. And then Corsi is just shots on goal, shots that miss the goal, and shots that are blocked, just to kind of give you a feel of total overall shot volume from a player on the individual level. Tons of upside as well. He's at 38 points on the season. Facing the Coyotes team, it's been very good defensively this season. They rank 6th overall in goals against, but they've been struggling a little bit lately, allowing 4-plus goals in 3 straight games. So with his high floor, I'm definitely not worried about it, and we know all about his upside. You compare him with Jeff Skinner and Sam Reinhardt if you were looking to stack in GPPs. That is the top line, top power play unit for Buffalo. If you want to go a little bit more of the balanced route, Eric Staal shows up on my projections tonight. Only 5,900 on DraftKings, 7,100 on FanDuel, so he's a little bit better value over there on DraftKings, but definitely playable in both. The Wild have the highest team goal projection tonight, right around 3.7, 3.8 goals. And then they play against a Panthers team that ranked 27th in road defense, allowing 3.9 goals per game. Staal's been solid all year. He's allowed 21, or he's had 21 points in 29 games. Also provided a high floor with 10.8 shots per 60 and 15.4 individual Corsi rating. And going back to the upside here, he's generating a very high 11.3 scoring chances per 60 minutes and 6.1 high danger scoring chances, both inside the top 5 among all centers tonight and inside the top 10 among all players tonight. So definitely like the floor and the upside for Staal tonight. I'm going to be playing him in all formats. Looking at the wingers, Timo Meier stands out for me tonight. 7,000 on DraftKings, so the price is really caught up there. Really stands out on FanDuel at 6,100. I believe that's just outside the top 10 in pricing over there amongst wingers. Off to a tremendous start of the season. He scored 21 goals in his first full season last year. He's already got 30 points in 29 games this season. He's earned his way to the top line with Logan Couture and Thomas Hertl, and he's playing on the second power play line with Evander Kane and Joe Thornton. So he's getting a ton of ice time and showing a very high floor. Like I said, he checks all the boxes. 11.5 shots per 60, 19.6 individual Corsi. Tons of upside with 13.6 scoring chances per 60 and 7.1 high danger scoring chances per 60, both right near the top of the league this season. Could be a little bit lower owned tonight against Dallas. The matchup isn't elite by any means, but I think that gives us a little bit of an advantage getting away from some of the chalky plays. And like I said, I like him on both sides, especially on FanDuel, where he's still in the low 6K range. Next up, we've got Andreas Johnsson. DK, 4,800. FanDuel, 3,600. He's been skating along Austin Matthews for each of the last 3 games. He's already got 2 multi-point efforts in that role. DraftKings has caught up to the price. He's at 4,800 now. Still some value there, still under 5K. Can still definitely consider him in all formats. But on FanDuel, he's a near lock for me in the mid-3K range. Just too cheap for second line in a game with a 6.5 total, skating beside an elite player like Austin Matthews, who's like just on fire since he got back from injury this season. Looking at defense, looking at Ryan Ellis myself tonight. If you have the salary, I love his teammate Roman Josi, who checks off all the boxes on defense, but he's just a little bit more expensive, and I'm looking to, you know, spend up a little bit, especially at the center position, a little bit more again at the winger position. So I'm going to be going with Ryan Ellis, 5,200 on DK, 4,800 on FanDuel. He's only got 4 points in his last 10 games, but he has provided a high floor with a balance of shots, 26, blocks, 19, which has been good for an average of 3.5 DK, 11.9 FanDuel points per game. Next up, going back to Buffalo Sabres here, I like Rasmus Dahlin. First overall pick this season. He's got off to a little bit of a slow start this season, adjusting straight into the NHL, but he hasn't really shown his upside yet, but he's been trending quite a bit lately with excellent value in the low 4K range. Over his last 10 games, he's averaging 3 DK and 10.3 FanDuel points per game, which is up from about the low 2 DraftKings, and I believe he's in the 6-7 range on FanDuel for the season, which is really good to see that trending up as he's getting a little more comfortable at the NHL level. He's now in the top pairing and averaging over 23 minutes of ice time per game in those last 10 games, which compared to a 20-minute average for the season. So definitely liking Dahlin tonight in all formats, especially in cash games in that low 4K range. So that covers all my core plays for tonight. Like I said, for more core plays, value plays, GPP plays, head over to grab a copy of the cheat sheet, which you'll find in our community chat or on my Twitter account, at @Jager_bombs9. You can hit me up with any questions there as well, same with the community chat. And I will be posting top stacks here very shortly, so make sure to check that out if you're playing GPPs, looking for those correlation lines and power play units that can win you a GPP tonight. Thanks for checking out the video, and we'll see you soon. Good luck.